My name is David Attenborough, and I gave the Christmas lectures on animal behaviour in 1973.
You might think that the orangutan would be a very good subject to try and teach to talk. Actually not so, and for quite interesting reasons, that the orangutan is, in the wild, a very solitary animal. This is a mantis, and he says beware by putting up his forelegs. His forelegs have got barbs on them, you see? Would you like a bit of a grape? Yes. I think the champion, the Royal Institution champion here, Wagler, for 1973 is probably... Yeah! Lord. So he too is ferocious. Now... There we are. Now, I regret to have to tell you... Ow!
In those days, they were all live. I found it an extremely difficult thing to do. Partly because I tried to remain true to the traditions of the lecture, which is that if you make a statement, you have to prove it. Now, that's okay when you're talking about producing carbon dioxide by pouring hydrochloric acid on marble chips, that's fine. But when you want to say something about animal behaviour, animals aren't just chemical substances, they have minds of their own. And also, not only that, but they have to run to time. So you had to produce a series of experiments in which animals were going to do things, and if they didn't do it in the time allocated, well, then you just had to move on to the next thing.
On his wrists, he has... he has little... I don't think it's going to work. No, I don't think it is. You know, I never liked mice.
Oh, I suppose 5 weeks to go, 4 weeks to go. I actually rang up the producer and said, look, I'll pay a lot of money. I'm just going to break my contract. I really can't do this. He gave me a strong cup of coffee and told me not to be silly.
If I get the gain turned up on this apparatus, indeed, quicker than I thought. That noise is produced by an egg. There he is. It is a porcupine, as you can see. Now, he's got a little alarmed, you see. You see, he's erected his quills. When he gets really angry, he lifts them up as though he was raising his hairs, so he looks even bigger and even more formidable. Knowing my luck, these two champion Indian hill miners will now, from this moment on, will be as silent as a grave. But there we are. Polly, put the kettle on.
Polly, put the kettle on.
I gave the lectures way back in 1973. It was a hair-raising experience, but I'm sure they're just as good today as they ever were, and I hope you'll enjoy them.